All right, now we got a guy at second, and now what we're trying to do, which is the whole game, is get the runner to third, man. Get the runner to third with less than two outs, okay? So we just talked about fours and late fours on that side with the runner at first. Now you could do fives and late fives on this side. Those are the bunts. So we could get there like this, and, okay, nothing happens. We could put a five right down there. We could show a little bit later, late five right there. It almost turns into like a little bit of a modified drag. Okay, and we can move a runner that way. You certainly can take the batted ball, that wand weapon we're talking about, right? And you can manipulate the ball to the right side on the ground. That's what we call the geo. Get 'em over. Get 'em over. It's a geo. And then basically, we just kind of have like a thumb system. If I looked at the hitter and I give him like this, you know, just some kind of subtle sign, this would say, take this pitch and hit it on the ground to the right side. If I went like this, it would say, take this pitch, son, and bunt it however you want. One, four, five, late four, late five, even a safety technique. I don't really care, whatever it is. Just your favorite way, how, why, just get them over to third base with some kind of bunt. And then this thumbs up would be like, it's like top shelf whiskey. It's top shelf, boy. You're just looking for yours right here. Don't worry about trying to hit them over on the ground. Don't worry about trying to bunt them over the ground. I just want you to try to be really aggressive and drive the ball. If you drive it to the right field fence and we move up that way, great. If you drive it deep to center and we move up that way, great. If you drive it to left and we don't move up that way, that's great too. Because in this system right here, checks and balances, like I referred to earlier, my primary concern is not having them get to third. I'd like them to, but if we don't, I give the kids the freedom. Okay? Well, this is going to come back into play in a minute. So we just talk about the right-handers tucking off the plate a little bit and the left-handers gaining on the plate a little bit. Why would I say that? Because if, remember deductive reasoning, what are they trying to do to me? Ha da ha da ha da ha. So I have to try to create some space. So if we can create a little bit of space, then I can actually get my hands or my chicken wing inside of this pitch that I know where they're coming, and I can try to manipulate this ball on the ground to the right side. If I'm a lefty, I know they're going to try to go over there because they want me to hit it into the teeth. Then I can get out to the three side of the ball, like we talked about in the prior talk. Then we can do that. These balls don't have to be hit hard. It might be one of your uglier swings of the day. It's okay. It's just like get it through. If we get a good one, we get on the ground, we could score. But at the end of the play, here or here or here, we got a guy at third base minimally. He's at third base minimally. Here, okay? So remember, it's not a hit and run. And if you get the two strikes, and it's on for the coach, one strike. It's on for the coach again. Now there's two strikes. For us, the plan goes out the door. Then we just go into our two-strike hitting from there. Okay, so we try to do it early. We might do it for two strikes worth, but once we get to two strikes, then I usually cut it loose and go to our two-strike plan. Stressing to them, too, this is a quality at-bat. It's a team at-bat. It's what I call half RBIs. You know what I mean? You hit them over, you tap them in. You each get a half. It's a pretty cool thing, but it gives the team the feeling of, like, I have some responsibility with that. You know, I talk about this back on a line drive. I know it seems kind of silly, but I think a lot of people talk about freezing. If you freeze on a line drive, you're going to get doubled up, okay? You have to have some back to jab, step back to something to get going. We talk about by the mound, through in front. Those are the ground balls. The clears the pitcher, and it gets through the front side, okay? It gets through the front side for you to move up. And then just like we just said, any time with nobody out, our objective is to get to third with less than two. So we're trying to apply the rule. When we have nobody out, our first instinct when the ball's hit in the air is we're looking to tag. From there, we just make reads about depths and all those types of things. If I don't, I don't. But if I'm, that's my first rule is that I'm trying to do. Okay? Any questions on that? You know, one thing I will say is when we get this situation like this, and we're playing this game, this little cat and mouse game. It's like if I give you this, it's okay to look for like a fastball in the inner third of the plate, right? Because if you think they're going to try to throw it in there to get you to hit it to the third base for the shortstop, and I give you thumbs up, it's like, back off the plate a little bit, guess fastball in, and like, let turn up the heat and wrap it up the foul pole, so to speak.